Cardinal Newman, one of the favorites in the North Bay League this year. A lot of people say Rancho Cotati should be right there with them. They match up later in the year, which is always a great game. Windsor proved that they are going to be a formidable foe. A lot of people have them picked as one of the stronger teams, and with their new head coach, Tom Kirkpatrick, they won last week over Petaluma. A good game. I was on hand for that. We had the highlights on YSN365.com, and Windsor looks good as well. St. Mary's will receive the opening kickoff tonight. Jack Murray kicks it away for Cardinal Newman, and Dewey Cotton, Mr. Electric, takes it inside the 10, quickly out past the 15, 20, spins there, gets out to the 25, took a couple of players to bring him down, but he finally did go down. First down, handoff, right side, big hole, first down, and more carrying the football and getting big yardage is Brandon Zahnbrecher, the returning running back. Urban Mann makes the tackle again, but Zahnbrecher reels off 15 yards. A little trouble with the snap, flips it out to Cotton. Cotton at the 40, makes a nice move there, gets to the 45, now to the 47 as he picks up about 5 yards there to make the tackle. Meeting him headlong, Michael Ortola and Chase Knowles, as that's a guy that you really have to be aware of. He is very dangerous when he gets his hands on the football.
Yeah, St. Mary's going to this fast-paced offense right now. They got Newman back on their heels a little bit.
Here's Zahnbrecher off the right side, and he has a first down at the 45-40. Still in the loose at the 30-yard line. Makes a cut there. Now the Cardinals catch up with him, and they drag him down from behind at the 20. But a big run right there for Zahnbrecher. Ballo Triola finally brought him down. Penalty marker, and this one is going to go against the Rams. It was on the outside, and it's a holding call. A couple of big runs to start the game for Zahnbrecher, but one of them erased. They go to him again, this time off the left side, and he gets past the 40, breaks a tackle at the 45-50, and taken down on the outside from behind by Damian Wallace. Wallace close, takes him down. There's a late penalty marker down near the end of the play. He's just short of the first down, and it's another hold against the Rams.
Well, that's a tough call right there. Zahnbrecher, what a nice run.
Going to the backup running back now, Sid Zaharian in the game. Man in motion is Cotton. They give it to Cotton on a little fly sweep. Cotton trying to get to the outside and pick up blocking. And the Cardinals converge. Nice job coming up and making the play. Jason Moran, he's a sophomore, a guy they really like. So third and 10, despite the fact that Cardinal Newman has given up close to 50 yards rushing here on the first series. A timeout. This is going to be taken by Cardinal Newman right before the snap. So obviously they saw something they did not like as the Rams came up to the line. So after the timeout, now it's a third and 10 from the 42 for the St. Mary's Rams. Dunaway takes the snap, in trouble, and he is sacked. Coming from the outside and getting him, Michael Ortola. And Ortola with a big sack, forcing the Rams into a punting situation. Damian Wallace, one of the guys dropping back deep for Newman. He returned a kick for a touchdown last year. He's standing with Brookshire, the quarterback, and Brookshire bobbles it. It is loose. Not sure who ended up with the football. Cardinal Newman got it back. Brookshire bobbled it, but managed to wrestle it away from one of the Rams. And some great receivers, Damian Wallace, Cody Baker, Jason Dietrich, they all had great games last week against Nail North. Here comes Brookshire. He pitches to Artola, and it is read well by the Rams. On the outside, Keaton Hampton with a hit as Artola just barely got back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 9, Brookshire to throw. Dietrich has it on a screen. Nice blocking. Dietrich to the 45, out to the 47-yard line as he picks up 7 yards. David Ford comes up and makes the hit. Brookshire's first pass is complete to Jason Dietrich. Swing this one out to Wallace, and Wallace has the first down as he splits the midfield marker and gets down to the 47-yard line. It is Michael Ruloke making the tackle. Brookshire completes his first two. Straight ahead it goes to Artola, and he runs into a brick wall of white and green. Michael Ruloke making the tackle along with Popo Omave. They think a lot of Popo Omave. He's a big guy. He goes over 300 pounds. Second down and about 7 from the 39.5-yard line. Brookshire to throw the out. And that one is incomplete on the outside. Pretty good coverage that time in the secondary.
You got to like the work of the offensive line right now. Those guys are giving Brookshire a lot of time to throw right now. And in running the football, they're getting man-on-man right now. They're doing a great job.
On third and 7, Brookshire keeps. Didn't carry much last week. Keeps this time, and he's close to a first down. Spins, and I think he got it on the spin, although He did take a hit after that, and a very big one. David Ford and Sid Saharian come up and make the hit along with Michael Reloque. And it is a first down as Brookshire spins his way down to the 41, a pickup of six.
Yeah, nice little quarterback draw on that.
He carries again this time, and he's got another first down. He's down inside the 25 to the 24 as he reels off 11 yards before Nick Herrera catches up with him. So Brookshire with a couple of very nice runs to Cardinal Newman, moving the football against St. Mary's. First and 10 at the 24. Brookshire looking to throw, sets up a screen. Ortola in space, has it at the 20, down to the 15. Takes a nice hit right there from David Ford, but manages to get to the 14, close to another first down. They'll move the chains again. First and 10 from the 14. They are in the red zone. Brookshire keeps after the fake, and he goes right up the middle and into the end zone. Touchdown, Cardinal Newman. Fake the fly sweep to Damian Wallace, and he kept it. Nobody touched him until he got down inside the five, and it was an arm tackle there that wasn't going to do the trick, and Brookshire scores.
I'll tell you, great job. I'm going to give it to the offensive line there. You know, being an offensive lineman, they are controlling that front. Both coaches said this game's going to be won or lost up front.
Jack Murray out of the hold of Derek Raffo will try and add the point now. 5:35 to go here in the first quarter. Good snap. Good hold. The kick is up, and the kick is good. So Cardinal Newman comes out and scores on their first possession. St. Mary's will get their hands back on the football when we come back. Tonight's game presented by title sponsor Cameron and Cameron Ranch and Vineyard Supply, delivering quality for over 40 years. North Bay Elite AAU girls basketball attending the top NCAA showcases in the country, with former players competing at the NCAA Division I, II, III, and NAIA levels, winners of two Pacific District Level I national qualifiers. For the best in girls AAU basketball, it's the North Bay Elite. Terry Heiner has been helping local student athletes develop strength and speed for sports performance for over 20 years. If you're trying to get to the next level for club, varsity, college, or pro sports, contact Terry Heiner now at 583-5720. Real results, real fast. The kickoff by Jack Murray is a short one taken by the Rams' Keaton Hampton, and he is nailed. Great hit, 24-yard line. Ian McMullen flying to the football on special teams. Special teams are always so important, and in a game like this, the Newman defense really got some help from the officials on St. Mary's first possession. Here comes the handoff off the right side, and this time Zombrecher is held for just a short game, as Chase Knowles gets to him first and brings him down at the 26-yard line, 2 yards on first down for Brandon Zonbrecher. Just under 5 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Plenty of time. The pass complete. Dunaway getting it to the outside, getting it to Keaton Hampton, and Hampton is taken down by Damian Wallace. Not much there. Maybe got a yard, and that's about it. Here comes Zombrecher, right side. Newman stretching it out, but Zombrecher breaks the tackle, gets close to the first down until he got down after he is knocked backwards by Michael Ortola. Second first down for St. Mary's. And an inside handoff this time to Zombrecher. And he is taken down by Balo Triola at about the 50. Well, they crossed the 50. They're down to the 49-yard line, so it's a pickup of 3 yards. Well, Newman is... got a lot of guys going both ways. This time it's a little swing pass out to Ontario Johnson. Newman's defense is all over it, and it's a loss of a couple of yards. Derek Rappo was the first guy on the scene, and they drop Ontario Johnson for a loss. Third and 9 for the St. Mary's Rams. Newman leading 7-0. 3:10 to go first quarter. A little bit of movement on the line. No call. Pass down the middle. Dewey Cotton dives for it and has it. Great catch at the 37-yard line. That is a first down as they pick up 17 yards and a first down. Looks very confident despite this being his first varsity game. Zombrecher off the right side. Little zone read, and he gets down near the 30-yard line, plunging forward for a gain of 8 yards. In on the tackle was Wyatt Darien and Spencer Almy. So give him, yeah, they'll actually give him about 7 yards. Check that. Joey DeMarco was in on the tackle that time. Clock ticking toward the two-minute mark. Here comes Zahnbrecher off the left side this time, and the Newman defense is there. Michael Ortola and Chase Knowles read that one perfectly. No gain that time.
Yeah, I'm telling you, I said it earlier, Michael Ortola is all over the field. He is in on almost every tackle, somewhere around the ball. I love the way this kid plays.
They actually lost a yard on that one, so third and four. Hand off straight ahead, nothing doing there. Great read right in the middle of the defense by Reed Palmer, and he drops him for a loss of a couple of yards.
Yeah, great job by Reed. Reed plays both ways, plays guard and defensive end.
From the 34-yard line, they need to get to the 29. Flags and whistles just before the snap. And Cardinal Newman took the timeout right there. Fourth down and about 5 yards to go for the Rams. Newman's defense digging in, bringing a lot of guys. The pass to the outside is caught out of the backfield. Dewey Cotton, who lined up in a slot, and he picks up 9 yards and a first down. So they'll move the chains. Nice call on fourth down. First and 10. Left side, Sid Saharan. Not much there as Michael Ortola meets him again. Triola was also in on the tackle. Under 30 seconds to go. It's only a gain of 2. As the first quarter comes to an end, Cardinal Newman up 7-0 after 1. We'll take a break right here and be back with the start of quarter number 2.
Highlights presented by Mead Clark Lumber Company, locally owned and part of the community for over 100 years. With the right information and the right materials, Mead Clark is the right lumber yard. So shop where the contractors shop, at Mead Clark Lumber.
Tonight's game presented by title sponsor Cameron and Cameron Ranch and Vineyard Supply, delivering quality for over 40 years. And we are ready for the start of quarter number 2. Rams at the Newman 25, looking deep, looking for the end zone, and it is caught. Hampton split the defense. Two defenders out there, and they couldn't stay with Keaton Hampton. Touchdown, St. Mary's. A 24-yard strike as we start quarter number 2.
I'll tell you, Dunaway put that ball perfect. Laid it right up there, split both defensive backs. You couldn't ask for a better throw.
And it just did barely get over. Jamois, who was doing the kicking, Roman Rubio, who expects to do a lot of their kicking, is injured tonight. So, again, the punting game and the kicking game is going to be an adventure. They got that one through, but we'll see. Extra points sometimes can be a big part of high school football. And he does like a little low squib type kick.
KSRO.
Ends up back in the hands of Damian Wallace. He had a touchdown last week. Opened the season with a 98-yard.
Cardinal Newman.
He gets out to the 29-yard line where he's met
or
by.
St. Mary's, excuse me, facing a
by the Rams there and brought down. But here it is, the handoff in the middle and not much doing. Nice hit right there. Reloke comes up and makes the hit. He is wearing 49. Inside screen this time, not much doing there as Dietrich gets
a little bit of yard
at the Newman 25, looking deep, looking for the end zone. 26 yards in the air, 4 of 5 for Brookshire thus far. Third and 5, showing blitz on the outside, but he might have come across. Marcus Aponte was trying to stop his forward momentum before he came into the neutral zone, but I believe they are going to call this encroachment. So first and 10, Cardinals out to the 39-yard line. Brookshire with 2 to the far side and 2 to the near side. And a timeout. Coach Cronin burning a timeout right here. One of the things we'll talk about a little bit at halftime is the division realignment. Here's Brookshire up the middle, big hole at the 50, down to the 45, tripped up there and dives forward. David Ford just got a piece of him, and he gets to the 42-yard line. Pickup of 17 yards for Jordan Brookshire, and the Cardinals are off and moving again. 4 carries and 48 yards for the Cardinal Newman junior quarterback. Brookshire looking to throw, looking deep. Gets it out in space. It's bobbled by David Ford, who almost picked it off. And then the ball almost landed in Gilbert Campos' hands. It was intended for Wallace in the seam, a little underthrown. Breaking free, but the ball did not get to him in time. Second and 10 now. Fake the fly sweep to Wallace. Brookshire keeps, and he is nailed. Mike Prefling comes up and makes the tackle, gain of just a yard. Third down, and Jason Dietrich on the far side of the field moved a little early that time.
Yeah, Brookshire is starting to try to hard count these guys, get them to jump offside a little bit. And what happened, his receiver jumps offsides.
Third down and 14 for Newman. Brookshire looking to throw. Lots of pressure. Brookshire trying to buy time, and he won't be able to do it. It is Reload. Comes with some heavy heat and the sack way back at the 44-yard line.
Yeah, you know, St. Mary's right now, they're saying that we're not going to sit back and play base anymore. We're going to bring some heat on this guy and make him have to beat us.
Number 17, Gavin Dove.
It was a loss of 15 yards. Gavin Dove, who's also the backup quarterback, he will do the punting tonight. Dove with a low kick, returnable, taken in space by Dewey Cotton. Cotton has some room to the outside. He's got a lot of room now at midfield, and Brookshire knocks him out of bounds. You ask yourself, why is Jordan Brookshire on the punt team? Well, that's why, right there.
He's
just
an athlete.
In case.
He's an athlete right there.
Insurance policy, just in case somebody breaks one. After that, it was Dove who was in line back there, and they knock him out at the 36-yard line. Here comes Zombrecker, left side. Ortola misses him. He gets to the 30, down to the 20. Still rolling, and he gets down inside the 15-yard line. Jason Moran finally runs him down. They're going to spot it right at the 20. He must have stepped out of bounds, but there is a penalty marker down, and it goes against St. Mary, so that'll back the Rams up about first and 19. Dunaway's pass complete near the original line of scrimmage. Flag going down. Mark Baschetti in on the tackle along with Irvin Mann. Personal foul. It's going to be a face masking call that goes against Newman. St. Mary's with their fifth first down. They spot it now at the 21-yard line, just under 8 minutes to go here in the second quarter. St. Mary's trying to take the lead. Dunaway a little trouble with the low snap. He ends up picking it up and keeping and taking a big hit, but he does pick up about 5 yards. Irvin Mann hit him very hard. He had to feel that one. Pistol formation. This time it's a good snap. Zombrecker left side. Ortola reads it well. He gets away from Ortola. Now coming up and mopping it up is Jason Moran. Damian Wallace thought he had stripped the football out late. It's at the 10-yard line, so it's going to be a first down. Zombrecker digging for some tough yardage. The Friday Night Lights show bringing you high school football here in the area. Here's Zombrecker off the right side. Gets down inside the 10 to the 7-yard line. Triolo with the tackle. Triolo having a good game defensively, but Zombrecker picks up 5 more yards.
Boy, Zombrecker, he runs low. He's about 2 feet off the ground. They get 195 pounds. He brings a load down there.
Second down and 5. Another low snap. Dunaway handles it. Gives it to Zombrecker. Zombrecker right side, diving down into the end zone, and he scores from 6 yards out. Power run, and it's a touchdown for St. Mary's as the Rams take the lead.
Yeah, they're running to the right side where their big boys are over there.
Kick is up, and the kick is good. So St. Mary's now takes the lead 14-7 over Cardinal Newman. Cardinal Newman will get their hands back on the football when we return to Friday Night Lights. Tonight's game presented by title sponsor Cameron and Cameron Ranch and Vineyard Supply, delivering quality for over 40 years.
At George Peterson Insurance, we support the communities we serve and live in. You'll find us helping out at the Boys and Girls Club and Sonoma Humane Society, collecting food for the Redwood Empire Food Bank, and more. It's our goal to make our neighborhoods a better place. We're invested in your success. For over 75 years, George Peterson Insurance has been serving our communities and customers with top-notch service and competitive pricing. Find out what we have to offer. George Peterson Insurance, we've got your back.
Hey, Rod. Montgomery in a 0-0 tie with Hayward at the end of the first quarter, so that one low scoring, moving right along. So that's our first live scoring update from Cameron and Cameron Ranch and Vineyard Supply. Montgomery 0, Hayward 0. at the end of one. The kick goes to Damian Wallace. Again, he returned one for a touchdown last week from the 5. Out past the 15. Hurdles someone there. Gets out past the 25 to the 31-yard line. A nice return. David Ford makes the tackle. Wallace gives Newman decent field position at the 31-yard line. Figures to start this year. Came off the bench for Tom Bonfili last year. Brookshire with a fake left. Rolls right, sets up, throws
second
coverage,
down,
and it's batted
and
down
five.
By Michael Rillo. Another low snap, Dunaway. Second and 10 after the incompletion. Paul Cronin signaling in the play. And here's an inside shuttle to Wallace. He gets to the 25-yard line, a gain of 4. But a nice job defensively again by St. Mary's as they begin to gain some confidence. Again, they graduated 10 of last year's starters. And we got a timeout now taken by St. Mary's on this third and 6. Fly sweep, Wallace in space. Nice open field tackle, 2 yards short of the first down. Again, the mystery man, number 24, who makes the tackle. Like Newman is going to go for it here on fourth down in their own territory at the 39-yard line. Fourth and 2, they need to get to the 41.
Trying a hard count.
Might be just trying to draw them offside. We'll see. They change the formation now. Brookshire calling it out. They're going to have to hustle to get this off. The count has started by the back judge. And they do snap it just before the call. Throw it to the outside. Wallace incomplete. He was covered well on the outside that time by Christopher Leonardini. And so St. Mary's takes over with 4:39 to go in Cardinal Newman territory. Jake Dunaway, who's completed 6 of 6 so far, having a good game. But this one's picked off on the outside by Wallace. Wallace at the 40, has a lot of room in front. He's the midfield, down to the 40, the 30, cuts back inside at the 20, still on his feet, down inside the 15, finally taken down from behind by the quarterback, Jake Dunaway. An interception, and Cardinal Newman has great field position.
Boys, interesting call both times. Now we get St. Mary's throwing the football. They're down deep, and they've been running the football against them. Very interesting call.
Brookshire keeps up the gut. Hurdles down and
6
spins.
So far,
kind of somersaulting.
Good game.
Yeah, quarterback, Jake Dunaway.
Now,
an interception.
4-minute mark.
And Cardinal
Brookshire
Newman
keeps again
has
up
great
middle.
Field position.
Tough sledding as he gets in just inside the 5-yard line. He's going to be a yard short of the first down.
I'll tell you, Brookshire is a load when he runs straight ahead.
Pretty dynamic. Over 3,000 yards rushing and passing combined. Doesn't happen a lot when you can, especially for a sophomore, to put up those kinds of numbers.
Exactly right. He did a great job last year.
Third and a little less than a yard now. They come up under center. One of the few times you'll see him do that. Pound it off the left side with Ortola. And he's going to be close. It'll depend on the spot. First and goal. They did pick up the first down. Seventh first down of the night for Cardinal Newman. Brookshire keeps up the middle looking for his second touchdown of the night. And he's in with a spin. Touchdown. Brookshire from 4 yards out. And Newman will have a chance to tie it back up pending the extra point.
Well, there you go. They're running the football. You know, Brookshire up the middle, Brookshire up the middle, Brookshire up the middle. That's what everyone said. They control the line of scrimmage and run the football at him.
4-yard run with 2:44 to go. Jack Murray on to try to add the point. Junior kicker.
Ball at him.
Good snap. Good rush
football,
put on
you know,
by the Rams.
The
and the kick is good by Murray. A lot of pressure coming. The holder, Derek Rappo, did a great job of getting that down. We're tied 14-14. 2:44 to go in the half. St. Mary's will get their hands back on the football when we come back.
Kerry Heiner has been helping local student athletes develop strength and speed for sports performance for over 20 years. If you're trying to get to the next level for club, varsity, college, or pro sports, contact Kerry Heiner now at 583-5720. Real results, real fast. Tonight's game presented by title sponsor Cameron and Cameron Ranch and Vineyard Supply, delivering quality for over 40 years.
So Cardinal Newman will kick it away now. Back and forth we go. Newman led early. St. Mary's scored 2 touchdowns. Cardinal Newman answered. Jack Murray's kick headed to Keaton Hampton at the 10-yard line. He's bringing it to the near side, looking for blocking. Cut back at the 30. 35 spins. Brookshire brings him down at the 37-yard line. And it's a sack in the backfield. Dunaway was never
with a spin.
Triola makes the tackle. A loss of about a yard. Montgomery won that matchup tonight in that girls' soccer game. 1-0, low-scoring match. Brookshire keeps up the middle,
Dunaway
looking for his second touchdown of the night. And he's in
tonight by the
with a spin. Touchdown. Brookshire
looking
from
to throw
4 yards out, and
Newman
will have a chance
a little
to
high,
and John Brecker couldn't quite get to it.
As 2 yards
out, and Newman will have a
minute
chance.
57 to go.
Yards out, and
the ball back with time, perhaps to put together a drive.
Dunaway to throw down. Third down over the middle, incomplete. Good coverage. Pass was intended for Ontario Johnson. Damian Wallace was on coverage. It will be fourth down. Sanders waiting for the snap. Minute and 53 to go. Newman will have time. It is a low kick. Takes a hop to Damian Wallace at the 35. Breaks a tackle there. Breaks another one at the 40 and steps out of bounds at the 41-yard line. He was forced out that time by Harris Heat. First and 10, Newman from the 41-yard line. Brookshire looking to throw. Sets up an inside screen. It's caught but immediately taken down. Jason Dietrich that time. Nick Herrera was in on the tackle. I'm not sure if they might have called that an incomplete pass, but bounced in. Yeah, now they're going to say they're going to rule that incomplete. They haven't come to this near side. Cody Baker, one of the slot receivers here on the near side. Brookshire is going to keep out past the 45, out to the 48. Swarm of white jerseys taken down there, led by Michael Reloque. As Brookshire, with some tough sledding, picks up 6, maybe 7 yards. Brookshire keeps, gets out past the 50 again. Big hit, but he got the first down at the 48-yard line. 45 seconds now to go here in this first half. Tied at 14.
He's going to have to get the ball down the field. There it is.
Brookshire with an inside screen this time to Cody Baker. The football's loose. Looks like St. Mary's has it at the 49-yard line, and they do. Picking up the football. Forcing the fumble was Popo Amave. And David Carleo, the lone returner on defense for St. Mary's, falls on the football. And now St. Mary's takes over with just 33 seconds to go. We'll see what Tony Franks wants to do here if they try to go for something deep. His offensive coordinator is Doug Carrusco. He's been with him all 15 years here. Actually, the first year he coached the sophomore squad, and then they brought him up to help with the varsity after that, but he has been here as long as Franks. A lot of movement on both sides.
They're having a lot of issues with that center snap back to the quarterback also. Rolled it back again.
And kind of interesting, when I asked Tony Franks what he played at Davis, he said he had played with you there, and he said he played offensive guard. Kind of surprised me. Doesn't look like a guy who would play offensive guard. Pass by Dunaway is caught. Ontario Johnson near the 40 has a first down. Took a couple of nice pinball hits. Wallace, one of the guys there. But it's a pickup of 12 yards. They do have a couple of timeouts to work with as they try and get themselves in position. Of course, the kicking game is a problem for them.
Timeout.
Under 20 seconds, they didn't take a timeout there, interestingly enough. Dunaway looking deep, looking for Johnson deep down the middle. He had a step, but the ball was overthrown by just a bit. There were three defenders down there, but Johnson had a step. We're down to 9.2. They could easily have 20, 25 seconds if they had taken a timeout there. Not sure what they're saving him for. Dunaway to throw. Good pressure. Going deep again, this time for Keaton Hampton. And this one is overthrown. Wallace was with him stride for stride. 3.5 to go. And it's third and long. He's looking deep. Steps up. Goes down. That's going to do it for the half. He ended up picking up about 5 yards, but Jamon Roberts dragged him down from behind. And a very tightly played, very exciting first half comes to an end with the score 14-14.
Yeah, that's just inexperience at the quarterback. When there's no time left, he's not going to run for a touchdown from way back there. Just got to let it go and see if something happens. He's got very good wide receivers, so just let it go.
Looking forward to a great second half. We are at halftime. The score is 14-14. We'll take a break right here and be back with more.
Tonight's game presented by title sponsor Cameron and Cameron Ranch and Vineyard Supply, delivering quality for over 40 years.
The longest running girls travel basketball club in Sonoma County, the North Bay Elite, is dedicated to helping student athletes with skills to achieve academic and athletic excellence.
You know, we buy quite an array of different products, and we buy a lot of apparel, hats, bags, t-shirts.
You know, we utilize almost all the services here at Cinema Design, from embroidery and screen printing, and we also use the business-to-business website in order to sell our products.
Really what stands out is the quality of the work that they produce. They take a lot of pride in delivering high-quality product.
So they really go above and beyond in terms of researching items, giving us just what we're looking for.
The staff here have been wonderful, from the artists to the staff out in the production line.
You know, they treat us as if they really value our continued business, which frankly in this economy is pretty rare.
Sonoma Design has not only been prompt with their deliveries, on-time deliveries, and that's why we use them.
St. Mary's to kick it off now as Cardinal Newman will get their hands on the football first to start quarter number three. Wallace back deep. And they're going to kick it right to him. He takes it at the 10. Quickly out past the 15 to the 20. Gets a block. The wedge trying to develop for him. But St. Mary's busts it up, and he gets out to the 28-yard line. Dusty Frampton in on the tackle. First and 10 now from the 27, 28-yard line. Quick pass out to Wallace. Tries to make some moves and may have lost a yard. Nick Herrera comes up and makes the tackle. Didn't quite get back to the line of scrimmage. And it's now second and 11. They actually lost a yard on that one. Brookshire out of the pistol. Fakes the handoff. Throws over the middle. Wallace again, but he can't dive and catch it. He left his feet. He was open over the middle. Coverage that time by Christopher Leonardini. It's incomplete. Third and 11. St. Mary's bringing the house. Brookshire gets it off. He's got Wallace at midfield. One man to beat. Wallace breaks the tackle, and he's gone. 20, 10, 5. Touchdown, Cardinal Newman. Leonardini tried to hang on to Wallace and couldn't do it. It's a 72-yard touchdown, and Cardinal Newman takes the lead.
Nice job. Beautiful throw. Little corner route. Get Wallace one-on-one with Leonardini. And, you know, it's just perfect throw out there. Just let Wallace run with the football.
First time Wallace has been able to. St. Mary's bring in the house from this. Jack Murray to try to add the point. Good snap. Good pressure again, but Murray gets it off, and it's good. So Cardinal Newman answers the bell here to start the third quarter. They now lead it 21-14. We'll be back with the kickoff. St. Mary's will get to touch it for the first time in the third quarter when we come back.
Highlights presented by Mead Clark Lumber Company, locally owned and part of the community for over 100 years. With the right information and the right materials, Mead Clark is the right lumber yard. So shop where the contractors shop, at Mead Clark Lumber.
Tonight's game presented by title sponsor Cameron and Cameron Ranch and Vineyard Supply, delivering quality for over 40 years. This one developing into quite a game as Brookshire hits Wallace for a long touchdown, 72-yarder. Murray to kick it off. Keaton Hampton has it at the 15, cutting into the middle of the field to the 25-30, has some space. Nice cut again out past the 35 to the 38-yard line, taken down by Jason Moran. And now it's St. Mary's turn with the football. Handoff straight ahead. Nope, it's a pitch out after the fake. They get it to Sid Saharian. He's out past the 50 and knocked out of bounds. Loses the football. Moran knocked him out at the 44. There's a late penalty marker down near the end of the play. Fourth penalty. All four penalties against St. Mary's have been holding calls. First and 16. Here comes Dewey Cotton on a fly sweep. Has some blocking down in front of him. Trying to turn the corner, and he can't really do it as Chase Knowles runs him down, the senior. Does a very nice job getting to the outside and pushing Dewey Cotton down after a gain of about 4 yards. Dunaway takes the snap, hands it off straight ahead, and Zombrecker. Zombrecker had 42 yards. Jamon Roberts takes him down after a short gain. He got to the 40-yard line. Dunaway throws, complete. Hampton has it over the middle, and he's got a first down in Newman territory at the 43-yard line. Wallace brought him down.
Boy, that was a great catch by Hampton on that.
Hampton, who had the big touchdown catch earlier. Now it's 37 yards. Here comes Cotton on the fly sweep, and he's got first down yardage again as he gets all the way down to the 32 before Balatriolo brought him down as St. Mary's gets their offense clicking now. A couple of quick first downs. Here comes Zombrecker. Bounces to the outside this time. Has the 25, close to the 20. See what the spot is down there on that far side of the field. As Newman quickly substitutes some beef into the lineup. Zombrecker left side. It'll be close. Nice hit on defense by Jalen Doral, who comes up and makes the stop. First and 10 now at the 22-yard line of Cardinal Newman. St. Mary's on the move. Swing pass. Dewey Cotton looking for a block. He gets it. It's close to a clip. It is a clip.
Oh, that
was tried to get his head in front, Keaton Hampton, and he couldn't quite do it. Roy Hammond, the white hat, was watching it all the way, and he didn't hesitate to throw his flag. It was close. He tried to get the head around. It was very close.
Yeah, that's a close one. It's too bad. I thought he got his head all the way across, but the white hat said no.
First and 20 now for St. Mary's. Down the middle, this pass a little high, intended for Cotton. Dunaway just overthrew him. End around, Dewey Cotton takes it, has some space, picks up a block at the 30, gets a first down near the 20, still on his feet at the 10,
yes.
Fumbles the football, and Brookshire has it. Now they're going to say he was down before the ball popped loose, I believe. Brookshire definitely came up with the ball.
That was a big hit on little Dewey Cotton, too.
And there's an injured Cardinal Newman Cardinal on the field. Got a 29-yard run for Cotton that time. 12th first down of the ball game for St. Mary's. Here comes Zombrecker. Big hole right side, plunging down inside the five. Coming up and making the hit, Jason Moran. Also there with Michael Ortola. He's at about the 2-yard line of second and goal. Zombrecker again, little delay, hit at the one and dropped. I don't believe he got in. It was close. Joey DeMarco, the 6 foot, 260-pound junior, was right there, and he knocked him back.
Yeah, Joey did a great job coming down the line there.
St. Mary's facing a third and goal from the one. See if they can punch it in. Zombrecker left side, and this time he does step across the line and in. Adam Jamois, his kick is up, and his kick is good, so we are tied. 21-21, 7:13 to go. We're in the third quarter.
Tonight's game presented by title sponsor Cameron and Cameron Ranch and Vineyard Supply, delivering quality for over 40 years. Kerry Heiner has been helping local student athletes develop strength and speed for sports performance for over 20 years. If you're trying to get to the next level for club, varsity, college, or pro sports, contact Kerry Heiner now at 583-5720. Real results, real fast.
So St. Mary's to kick it off here on Key Auto Body Friday Night Lights, 7:13 to go. And they're kicking it to Wallace again, living dangerous. Wallace bobbles this one. He's got to pick it up at the one-yard line. Here come the Rams, and they converge on him at the five. Slipped through his hands. He had to retreat to pick it up, and Dusty Frampton made him pay for that. So Cardinal Newman with terrible field position. Jordan Brookshire on a keeper. Gets a little breathing room as he gets about 2 yards off the right side before Alec Ramirez. Roy Harwell, number 20. We finally figured out who number 24 is. It's Roy Harwell. Second down and a long eight. He got almost two, not quite two, on first down. They could use a little breathing room. Here comes Brookshire again. He breaks a tackle. Gets out past the 20. Out to the 25-yard line. A big run. Right up the middle by Brookshire. Brandon Sanders makes the tackle. First and 10, Cardinal Newman from their own 24-yard line. Brookshire looking to throw. Has time. Lofts it up deep. Dietrich out there. Has it at the 48-yard line. Alex Cetus was a little late on coverage that time. And it's a first down. Rancho Cotati has scored again. They now lead at 35-6. Handoff to Artola, and he's nailed at the line of scrimmage. Great hit right in the middle of that defense. Mike Prepling was there at the high school level. Brookshire straight down the middle to Wallace. Wallace makes a tackle, and he's gone. 20, 10, touchdown, Cardinal Newman. Little seam route. Had two defenders there, but he broke both tackles, and it's a 53-yard touchdown for Wallace, his second long touchdown of the second half.
Yeah, Wallace is exciting. Boy, he slips right into that seam. Brookshire plenty of time to get rid of the football, waits for it, hits him on a strike, and it's gone.
St. Mary's has brought some good heat from the far side on the outside. They do it again, and he slides it low, but he got it through. Just barely. Nobody's blocking that outside guy.
No, he's coming.
He's getting really close. So 28-21, Cardinal Newman retakes the lead. They've scored on both their possessions in the second half, and now it's St. Mary's turn to get the football.
You know, we buy quite an array of different products, and we buy a lot of apparel, hats, bags, t-shirts.
You know, we utilize almost all the services here at Cinema Design, from embroidery and screen printing, and we also use the business-to-business website in order to sell our products.
Really what stands out is the quality of the work that they produce. They take a lot of pride in delivering high-quality product.
So they really go above and beyond in terms of researching items, giving us just what we're looking for.
And the staff here have been wonderful, from the artists to the staff out in the production line.
You know, they treat us as if they really value our continued business, which frankly in this economy is pretty rare.
Sonoma Design has not only been prompt with their deliveries, on-time deliveries, and that's why we use them.
Back and forth we go here on Kyoto Body Friday Night Live. It's Cardinal Newman back up 28-21 over St. Mary's of Stockton. Jack Murray's kick end over end, taken at the 15-yard line. Keaton Hampton straight up the middle, has a couple blocks, makes a nice move, breaks free out near the 45 and gets all the way out to midfield. Finally taken down by Ortola, as who caught him from behind.
That has Joe Smiley in the studio. Cardinal Newman,
right side, he has blocked the
seam route
down to the 30.
Finally two defenders there, but he broke
behind
tackle
Moran at the 20-yard line.
3-yard
touchdown for Wallace, 25-yard touchdown, 30-yard run, and for once, after a big run, there's no penalty marker down. Now Creo up 14-12 over Annalee at the half. Here comes Zombrecker left side, this time only a couple of yards, as Ortola brings him down. Will be in action. Zombrecker carries this time for four more yards. Going to make it a third and two. 107 yards on 19 carries now for Zombrecker.
Well, Zombrecker, the workhorse. They just got to keep getting the ball in his hands. He makes things happen. Runs low, he runs hard.
And timeout taken by Newman. Paul Cronin did not like his alignment that time, personnel-wise, so he's going to take a little timeout. Also, I think important to give his players, especially the guys going both ways, a little bit of a breather now and then, especially just before a big play like this. We are in the third quarter, third and two. They brought in a fullback, and they give it to him right up the middle, Sid Saharan. And I don't think he got much, but it's going to be close to the first down. He got about a yard and a half, but he's a half yard shy. It's going to be fourth and one. 2:33 to go. Zombrecker, right side, and he does get the first down. Nice hit coming up and putting a helmet on him was Balo Triolo. He's had a very good football game, but Zombrecker's momentum carried him for that yard. Fakes it to Zombrecker. He keeps on the outside. Coming up and hitting him hard is Ortola, but he refuses to go down. Finally does at the five-yard line after a gain of four. Ortola made the initial contact, and then a couple of other Cardinals came and mopped it up. Dunaway, excuse me, at 6'1", 192. Here comes Zombrecker, right side. Down inside the five, close to the end zone, and he's in. Touchdown. Zombrecker from 5 yards out. Carries it across again. What a night for him. His third touchdown run of the night. Short kick, but it just does trickle over. Adam Jamoas gets that one to go. So we are all tied up at 28-28 with 1:24 to go in the third.
The longest-running girls' travel basketball club in Sonoma County, the North Bay Elite, is dedicated to helping student-athletes with skills to achieve academic and athletic excellence.
highlights presented by Mead Clark Lumber Company, locally owned and part of the community for over 100 years. With the right information and the right materials, Mead Clark is the right lumber yard. So shop where the contractors shop, at Mead Clark Lumber.
So 1:24 left here in this third quarter, and what a third quarter it's been. Both teams have had the ball twice. Both teams have scored twice. Kickoff heading for Wallace. He's going to let this one fly, hoping that it goes out of bounds, and it doesn't. It hits into the corner, bounces into the end zone, so Cardinal Newman will start at the 20-yard line. Brookshire keeps left side, has five,
excuse me, at 6'1", 192,
gets to the 25-yard line.
Zumbrecker, right
side,
Ford
comes up down inside the five, close up. 81 yards, 14 carries for Brookshire. He's scored three touchdowns tonight. It's as the third quarter comes to an end. So we are tied up 28-28, three quarters of play in the books here on Key Auto Body Friday Night Lights. The fourth quarter coming up. Hang on, it's going to be a good one.
Tonight's game presented by title sponsor Cameron and Cameron Ranch and Vineyard Supply, delivering quality for over 40 years.
At George Peterson Insurance, we support the communities we serve and live in. You'll find us helping out at the Boys and Girls Club and Sonoma Humane Society, collecting food for the Redwood Empire Food Bank, and more. It's our goal to make our neighborhoods a better place. We're invested in your success. For over 75 years, George Peterson Insurance has been serving our communities and customers with top-notch service and competitive pricing. Find out what we have to offer. George Peterson Insurance, we've got your back.
We begin the final 12 minutes of this one with Cardinal Newman facing a third and two from their own 28-yard line. Brookshire fakes the handoff, keeps, spins, and gets the first down as he just does get beyond the 30. He was hit by Harwell behind the first down marker, but spun away and gets 3 yards. Looking to throw this time, swings it out to Wallace in space. He has the 35, out past the 40, close to another first down as Wallace picks up 10 yards. Ford and Herrera in on the tackle for St. Mary's. The ball just beyond the 40-yard line. They need to get to the 42 for the first down. Fake it to Ortola. Brookshire keeps, dives, and has a first down at the 45-yard line. Shuffled his feet, saw a little opening, and then just went airborne over the pile and picked up the first down. Cardinal Newman will throw down the middle. Traffic caught by Wallace at the 41-yard line, tripped up by Alex Cetus, but it is a pickup of 12 yards and a first down. He's going to throw again, play action, throws it out to Ortola, who juggles but has it at the 40, still on his feet, digging near the 35-yard line, and he picks up about 8 yards on that. Boy, that was a tough catch. He had to catch it one-handed in stride. Brandon Sanders makes the tackle that time.
Yeah, great catch by Ortola again. Both sides of the football, that kid can get it done.
Second and two now from the 35-yard line. 9:44 to go in this one. Cardinal Newman trying to put points on the board and eat up as much clock as possible. Brookshire keeps, loses the handle, and St. Mary's has it at the 35-yard line. He was stripped of the ball as he tried to spin out of trouble. And it's St. Mary's who comes up with the football. Big play right there. Left side, it is Saharian, and he has big yardage at the 40, 35, 30, 25, 20. He spins and gets all the way down inside the 10-yard line. Mark Muschietti caught up with him, but Sid Saharian, the junior, with a huge run.
That was a great run. Read his blocks very well. They just run that zone to the left a little bit, read the block.
And we're going the other way. Saharian off the right side this time, upended by Moran.
Shire
came up and
goes over 200 yards
on the night. Wow, he didn't get much of a spot that time. They actually spotted at about the 9-yard line. I thought he had more like about the 7. Here comes Saharian again, fourth time in a row, and Cardinal Newman trying to stop him. It's close to the end zone as the offensive line pushed him forward.
Well, they just run that zone to the left a little bit.
Straight ahead, good hit. Don't think he got there.
The rest is on him. He did a great job.
Nice line serve by Cardinal Newman. Saharian, big hole right side. He dives for it, and he's in. Touchdown. Big series for Saharian, and they take the lead now with 7:09. So 35-28 now. It is St. Mary's leading Cardinal Newman. Damian Wallace takes the kick. He'll get a chance for a return just inside the 10. Looking for blocking. Squirts out past the 20 to the 26-yard line. Taken down by Harry Brown. St. Mary's has done a great job on that kickoff team, bottling him up in the middle. He's had a couple of big runs. This time it's just a couple of yards for him. 19th carry of the night. Second and 8 now. Brookshire looking to throw, looking for Dietrich. Ball a little overthrown. There was a bump by David Ford, but the ball was a little over his head, and it's going to make it a third and about 8. Third and 8, unless they pick up this first down. 2 to the far side, 2 to the near side. Brookshire buying some time, fires this one a little low, intended for Wallace. He's waiting for someone to break free. Good coverage deep downfield. David Ford on coverage that time on Wallace, and Hampton had Dietrich covered deep. Fourth and 8.
They're going to go for it.
Yeah, they are going to keep the offense on the field here and try to pick up this first down. Brookshire on fourth down, lofting it up just a little bit long. Ortola was wide open. He put air under it, and Ortola couldn't catch up at the 45-yard line, and Cardinal Newman turns it over on down.
Todd, what a nice call, though. A little wheel route. Wide open, he just didn't get it to him.
Here comes Zombrecker back in the game, and the Newman defense is right there on top of him after a short gain. 5:40 to go. Cardinal Newman only has one timeout left. Pitch it out, Zaharian. Newman has it read well after the fake up the middle and a gain of just 1. Michael Ortola comes up and makes the hit. They're really playing run all the way right now. It's going to be 3rd down and 7. Approaching the 5-minute mark here in the fourth quarter. St. Mary's up 35-28. Dunaway to throw and almost intercepted.
Wow.
Jason Moran, the sophomore, had it right in his hands. Red, great coverage, and it's now 4th down. And I believe St. Mary's will go for it here. That would have been a huge turnover. St. Mary's will go for it here. 5 minutes to go. The clock stopped, and now a timeout taken by the Rams. 4th down, and St. Mary's, after the timeout, is going to go for it here with 5 minutes to play. 4th and 7 for the Rams. Dunaway takes the snap, looking to throw. He's in trouble, and he goes down. A penalty marker down late. Jordan Kabiko made the sack. And it's a holding call that goes against St. Mary's that will be declined. So Cardinal Newman's going to take over. Brookshire swings it out, incomplete. Intended for Wallace. A little off target right now. Brookshire's last few passes have not hit their mark. Nothing doing there. Reloke hits him after a gain of just 1. Annaly apparently driving late in the third quarter, trailing 14-12 to Maria Creo. But Brookshire shut down now. His last few runs have been all under 5 yards. Brookshire looking to throw, looking over the middle, a little bit of a bump on Wallace, and this one's going to get called. Sadis got there early. Pretty easy call for the official, and it's going to give Newman 15 yards and a first down, a much needed first down for the Cardinals. This should give them the ball out at about the 46-47 yard line. 3:58 to go in this football game. Fake it to Ortola. Brookshire trying to break free. Spins past the 50. Gets down to the 49-yard line where he's taken down by David Corralejo, the lone returning starter for this St. Mary's team. Fakes the handoff, and he's looking to throw. Rolling out, dumps it for Wallace, who makes a great catch. Ball was thrown a little bit behind him through a defender's hands, and Wallace hangs on. Ford brings him down. It's close to a first down at the 43-yard line. And Roy Hammond says, "What do you see? I told you guys, I had this all the time."
The eagle eye.
So 3rd and inches now for Newman. No doubt 4-down territory for the Cardinals. Clock will roll under 2 minutes and 40 seconds remaining.
takes it. He's going to throw here on third down. He's going to throw deep. He's got a man, and it's overthrown. Cody Baker was the intended receiver as the Cardinals take a chance and go deep. Brandon Sanders on coverage right there. Comes up under center this time, and they get some movement on the left side.
That hurts.
Wow. So now you go from fourth and inches to fourth and five on the false start. Coach Cronin is going to call a timeout. He's got to make sure he's got the right play at the right time right here.
He was hard counting. He was trying to get him to jump off.
So here we go out of the timeout. Fourth and five. Three receivers to the far side, two to the near side. No back this time with Brookshire. Wallace goes in motion. They fake it to him, and Brookshire keeps. He's got the first down. He's at the 40. Picks up some great blocking and gets down the sideline to the 27-yard line. Wow, he picks up 21 yards on that fourth down play. Three receivers to the far side,
right
to the near side
this time.
Brookshire's going to throw over the middle. Wallace goes in motion. They fake it to him, and Brookshire keeps. He's got the first down. He's at the 40.
To another first down. No back this time with Brookshire.
Wallace goes in motion. They make it to him. Wallace over the middle.
Yeah, you never know. So here we go. Out of the timeout. Fourth and five. Three receivers to the far side.
Right
to the near side
this time.
Brookshire's going to throw over the middle.
Wallace
goes in motion. They make it to him. And Brookshire keeps. He's got the first down. He's at the. Brookshire fakes the handoff. Swings it out to Ortola. Ortola has it at the 15. Doesn't break the tackle as Reloke runs him down at the 12. Michael Reloke makes a terrific play. One-on-one. Had to bring him down or Ortola was going to get inside the 5. Under a minute to go now. Cardinal Newman facing a 2nd and 6. Brookshire on a quarterback draw. He's going to have to try to hit the first down. He does, and he scores. Brookshire breaks free. He was pinballing his way through. They had him near the first down marker, and he ends up breaking free and squirting into the end zone. And now Cardinal Newman will try to go for the win. Same formation they used on fourth down. Will they run the same play? It is the same play, and Brookshire dives. Did he get there? No indication. Is he in? It's very, very close. I don't think they're going to give it to him. The Rams have held him inches short.
Oh.
Wow.
What a great call, boy. I tell you, that is like.
Brookshire's got his arms stretched across the line. He thinks he got in, but the officials spot it short. Wow.
Oh, what a run.
Tough to tell from this angle. Ooh. Brookshire's arm was stretched out across the line. Of course, the question is, where was the ball when his knee went down? Which is really, from our angle right here, nearly impossible to tell. I could tell it was close. He was either on the line or just short of the line. A game of inches, no doubt. It's 35-34. Five guys on the far side, four guys on the near side. St. Mary's loads it up. The kick bobs and weaves. Does it go 10 yards? I'm not sure. Someone dove for it. It ended up going out of bounds.
Oh, boy.
Wow.
They almost got that.
And with 44 seconds left in the game, they can take a knee right now.
Yeah.
And they're going to get out of here with a one-point victory, barring a disaster. Wow. What a tough way for this one to end.
They should have had that, too. That was close. You're talking about 6 inches either way, you know. So it was what a great call.
This one is a final. St. Mary's 35, Cardinal Newman 34. The two-point PAT comes up, we'll call it inches short. I'm not even sure if it was inches, but that's the way this one ends.
Wow. Tough way to lose a game tonight. They played really well.
Terrific football game. Could have gone either way, but St. Mary's gets it done. 35-34 for Cardinal Newman.